Anastasia impressed in her Grand Slam debut last year. You may recall she took Wayne Mardell right to the wire in a memorable group stage game. Based at Ellesmere Port on the Wirral, she's on the brink of moving into the PDC's top 100, and Anastasia has been talking to Ned.
Anastasia, welcome back to Wolverhampton. Last year, you nearly beat Wayne Mardell, and you had him very, very worried. Do you have good memories of last year?
Oh, yeah, of course. I'll never forget it. It was such a great experience, so hopefully it's all going to be a big plus for me this year.
I'm absolutely sure of that, but what a way to start. Phil Taylor. That's the hardest game in darts, isn't it?
Oh, well, yeah, well, he's no doubt the best player in the world, and obviously I was so lucky to play him in the first round.
Now, you just told me you have played him before. In fact, it was on Tuesday night in an exhibition. What happened?
Well, yeah, we opened the lane for Riley's in Gillingham, and we had the last game on Mainfield, best of three, and no comment.
No comment.
No.
But maybe you hope for better tonight.
Yeah, much better.
Good luck, Anastasia.
Thank you very much.
Facing Anastasia, a darts player who needs precious little introduction.
Well, Phil, first things first, nice tash.
Thank you, thank you. It's in support of John Artson, that's why I'm groaning. I'm groaning for 1 month, and it's for the cancer, you know, for make people aware what's going on in the downstairs. That's what it's for John.
Very good cause. Now, let's talk about the Grand Slam. And, of course, Phil, this is the third year, and the trophy's got your name written all over it.
Actually, we can't find the trophy. We lost the trophy, believe it or not. So it's obviously it's got my name on it, but not last year because we can't find it. But I'm really. This is a massive tournament on the calendar for us. There isn't one player in here that doesn't want to win this as much as the World Championships. I'll be honest with you, it's a massive tournament for us.
And of course, you're facing Anastasia.
Yeah, it's going to be tough for Anna. It's going to be tough for me, I think. I wouldn't say it was going to be the best game in the world because I think both of us will be a bit respectful of each other, I think. But I'm going to try. I'm going to try my best.
We know you will. Good luck.
Thank you, Jay. Thank you.
The former women's world champion against the current men's world champion at a decidedly noisy and expectant civic hall in Wolverhampton to get the players out once again. John McDonald.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back live to the action. We're at the Wolverhampton Civic Hall. It's the partypoker.com Grand Slam of Darts, brought to you by the Professional Darts Corporation. And we're live on ITV4. Here we go. Ladies and gentlemen, from Russia with love, the former ladies champion of the world, Anastasia Dobromyslova!
a freshly moustached Phil up against Anastasia at the Grand Slam of Darts. That's what Saturday nights are for. In the books for us, Chris Mason and John Rawley.
Thank you, Matt. The Civic Hall here is absolutely rammed. The bars have emptied. There is not a spare seat in the house. And for many a darts fan, Phil Taylor is what it's all about. Now 49 years old and the number one player in the world. The power. You heard him given the big introduction. And is this a thankless task for Anastasia, or will she be sharpened up for the rest of the tournament by the experience of playing against Phil, who we are told, Chris, there we are, ranked number one in the world and twice the Grand Slam champion, has been trimming his flights for even greater effect.
Well, I've just heard this evening. He's actually got an original set of his flights and he started to trim them down himself, and he's been using them for a week, and he says he's better with them than he was before.
The triangular shape there is something he's achieved, and there's Anastasia, 25 years old, lives in Ellesmere Port nowadays, married to Tony Martin, a professional darter himself, and she's got a reputation of being one of the most likeable people on the tour.
Yeah, she's a lovely girl, and she's a fabulous dart player. I've had the privilege of doing exhibitions with her, and she is absolutely superb.
After she's finished here, she'll be heading off for Russia to play in the World Championship qualifiers. I just wonder, is she on a hiding to nothing, or if she does manage to take a leg here, there would be a huge ovation from the crowd.
Absolutely, and it's not beyond her. I mean, this girl can go out in 12 darts, no problem at all. I've seen it, and I've played against it. She's more than capable.
First leg,
it's a big ask, a lot of pressure.
Throw first.
And we know what Taylor's all about. He can beat the best players in the world 5-0.
Well, he averaged that 118, didn't he, in the quarterfinals of the European Open recently, which is just startling. Be a big, big odds-on bet that Taylor wins this one 58. By 5-0, but that's a distinctly fallible and mortal opening. Let's see if Anastasia can capitalise.
Oh, that's a great first start.
66.
She'll have to shake up a bit of nerves. Problem with this though, John, short course. She's not going to have a lot of time to settle into a rhythm.
If Phil Taylor's going to be vulnerable,
140.
You would suspect it's going to be in these early stages, the short format.
The first three darts.
The thing I find astonishing, this is good from Anastasia,
100.
The thing I find astonishing about Phil, and which I have so much admiration for, is that he's achieved so much, and yet he's still, as we've said, trimming those flights and still in search of perfection, still getting better.
Well, he's looking for that extra 1 or 2% now to his game. I mean, this is a sport that I never thought I'd see mastered in my lifetime, but he's almost done that. You know, there's nothing else you can say about that man and what he's achieved. And what amazes me, it was nearly 20 years ago he won his first world title.
140.
Well, listen to the reception of the crowd for Anastasia as she produces three terrific darts from Russia with love, and they love her in Wolverhampton.
59.
Well, she's got a chance in this leg. Put a bit of pressure on Taylor.
Taylor on 104. Treble would be nice. And gets it. Right, 104.
Treble 18 would be his first star, I would have thought. No. 12 for double 16 and 4 for tops. 4 tops for the first leg.
Game shot in the first leg. Phil Taylor.
The glimmer of an opportunity for Anastasia never came, and there's a few pantomime boos from the crowd.
He still remains one of the most popular players on the circuit. The fans absolutely love him, but I think they'd just like to see Anastasia just take the leg and give Phil a bit of a game.
Phil went through a moustache phase a few years ago.
Yeah, he's had a few moustaches.
140.
I'll leave it for others to comment on whether or not it improves the looks.
55.
I think when he won his first title, yeah, he had a moustache.
He had a moustache when he played Dennis, didn't he?
And I'm sure when he played Mike Gregory in that wonderful final. Like I said, that was nearly 20 years ago.
140.
And somehow he just gets better every year. I don't know how he does it.
Yet to get a 180 in this tournament this year. Twice the winner, beat Andy Hamilton in the first final, then Terry Jenkins.
100.
And looking to set it up here.
Oh, I know we're only into the second leg.
100.
That's pretty handy. Check out the average, Chris. 120.13.
Yeah, that's a little bit special. 100. Phil reaches those dizzy heights, you know he's not really
97
going to drop that much, if anything 41. At all from that. He will now, of course.
Double 16 for the second leg. Anastasia breathes again, but a long way back. He'll have another visit.
Well, she should use this one just as a bit of a practice throw, try and put a bit of pressure on Phil. There we go, you see a lot of players at big scores at these points. So they just throw them nice and natural.
Fury require 8.
Double 4 for 2-0.
Game shards in the second leg. Phil Taylor.
Fueled by the desire to improve, the desire to win, and accrue a fortune. He now holds every single ranking title.
It is remarkable how he keeps raising the bar. And the others have to follow him.
100!
He's earned a few quid in the process.
Just a few.
£3.2 million.
60!
Plus a few exhibitions thrown in.
Well, yeah, that's just his prize money. I wouldn't like to pay his tax bill, that's for sure.
96.
Well, the crowd admiring the brilliance of Taylor, but how they would love to see Anastasia just put herself into a position to maybe win a leg.
40.
Not like that. Wee bit unlucky. 40. You know, aside from those major tournaments I'm talking about, Chris, he's had 12 PDC Pro Tour event victories as well.
Yes,
in 2009.
And I think he only attended 14, I think. His record this year has just been phenomenal.
And to though 59.
We did see a rare defeat, all but on the internet, but at Colin Osborne.
Yeah.
Well, in the last game, managed to get a surprise win. Another 19 leaves double 16.
I think he's gone for a 9.
Yeah, he switched upstairs for a 9.
So for 3-0, it is turning out to be, I'm afraid to say, from the Russian lady's perspective, it's turning out to be the steamrolling anticipated, and there's leg number 3.
Phil Taylor. Fourth leg, Anastasia to throw first. Game on.
Great determination there from Anastasia. She's been unlucky. She's pinning that dart around the 60. Good switch. That's great dart. That's what she's capable of.
Superb switch, wasn't it? She played in the Grand Slam last year. And it was against Wayne Mardell, wasn't it? He was under a lot of pressure. I think it's what Alex Ferguson calls squeaky
96.
Bum time, isn't it? He just
was.
Came through at the end.
It was memorable, yeah. She played Borough well last year. I think she had a good performance against Kevin McDyne as well, I'm sure.
Indeed.
59.
John Part was the other one in that
That's
group.
That's right. who's coming up later against Kevin Painter.
140.
Back on 308. Good switch again.
97.
Yep, she's using the board well. Good thinking. This is where Taylor's so special from around this point.
140.
This event has grown into a real highlight now of the darts calendar. In its third year, and it's a tournament which has been just dominated by Phil Taylor.
125.
Now, 125.
He'll go for the ball. 60 now for Tops. The reason he went that way is because he hit the ball. He would have stayed there. But Tops for a 125 and 4-0.
Boom. 105.
Big chance now for Anastasia.
111, and she's going to get a leg. You suspect that this is the opportunity. That's a great first dart. Tops she requires. Oh, the crowd was just willing that one in. And now Phil Taylor, double 10 for 4-0 at the break. 1 dart required. The world number one can almost sense victory. It's 4-0. It's a packed house in Wolverhampton. Anastasia is four down now on Phil Taylor.
Fifth leg, Phil Taylor.
It's always likely to be
first.
A Taylor victory, of course.
Game on.
But my word, they'd have raised the roof, wouldn't they, if she'd managed to get that double in.
Yeah, you could see she just pulled the dart, put so much into it.
Taylor averaging 110. Here are games to come this evening. John Part against Kevin Painter. On paper, that could be a cracker. Then Daryl Fitton against the ITV wildcard qualifier, Steve Mache.
41.
And finishing up with Mark Webster, the Welshman, against the Dutchman, Vincent van der Voort. Don't blink when he's playing.
Now, some exciting matches coming up. Really looking forward to John Part and Kevin Painter.
43.
Painter always comes to play, as does John Park.
The power in action, and a lot of people have come to see him. Anastasia's average there would have given her a decent chance
85.
Against Colin Osborne and Colin Lloyd.
Absolutely. She's not doing a lot wrong.
Taylor just relentlessly advancing towards the victory that we expected. The bookies said 5-0, and so it is working out almost inevitably.
60.
That dart had gone in, of course. What was it, 111, almost a checkout on
was.
That?
Yep.
Good last dart.
Just going through the motions now. 45. Will he finish off with the bang jump?
Well, he'll want to. He'll want the spectacular finish. Two treble 20s and a double 10 would give him 140. Not to be. Single 20 for double Tops.
100.
Well, I think she's done herself proud, Anastasia. I know she won't be happy with her performance. But it's a big ask, taking on the power.
140.
Wonderful throw to finish off
Phil
with.
Require 40.
Double top then for 5-0 for Phil Taylor. And game one dot required. Taylor completes the whitewash. And that, I suspect, is the sort of performance we'll see a great deal from Phil Taylor this week. He beats Anastasia by 5-0.
Not a shock. Taylor at a canter, double top for 5-0 against Anastasia. The man with the tash is up and running in search of his third Grand Slam. The stats look like this. Just the 106 nearly for Phil as an average. Anastasia, perfectly respectable, 81 plus. Phil just hit the one maximum, but 5 out of 9 with the checkouts, and it was more than good enough. Let's hear from both players. They are downstairs with Janie.
Congratulations, Phil. I'll talk to you first. You've just said that was awful, because you're friends, aren't you?
Yeah, I love her to bits. She's like my little daughter. She was stopped at my house 2 days ago. I absolutely love her to bits, and it was very difficult, I think, for both of us there to play a proper game. It was not nice for us.
Were you pleased with your performance?
Well, I don't think it was too bad. Not my best, but I just died. I got what I deserve, Phil played better, and that's it. Simple.
And it must be hard to start the Grand Slam this year facing Phil Taylor.
Well, to be honest, if I have to play Phil Taylor, I would prefer to play him first round, so good was good warm-up for me for next game.
And I must say, it looked like the crowd didn't really know who to support. We had everyone voting for you, going, yeah, yeah, come on. And then, of course, Phil Taylor, how can he not support you?
Yeah, yeah, yeah. I think it was split there a little bit, you know what I mean? I think Anastasia is a one-track mind. She's a winner. And unfortunately, you know, it's not tonight, but she's a great player. She really is. And her potential hasn't even started yet, you know. She's chucked herself in the deep end. She's come in with the big boys now, I think, anyway. And she's having a go, you know, and God bless her. And she's learning very, very quickly, and it's difficult for her, you know. Even for me tonight, it was difficult for me, but she'll be ready for tomorrow. She just said, you know what, Phil, that's probably the best practice session I've had for tomorrow.
Yeah.
And she's got that little bit of a bit between her teeth now, so I'll pity the fellow that plays her tomorrow, because he's going to get it.
Me too. Love the positive mental attitude, and congratulations, exactly. Phil.
Thank you, thank you.
Thank you.
And now Phil Taylor, double 10 for 4-0 at the break. One dot required. The world number one can almost sense victory. It's 4-0. It's a packed house in Wolverhampton. Anastasia is 4 down now on Phil Taylor.
Fifth leg, Phil Taylor.
It's always likely to be
first.
A Taylor victory, of course.
Game on.
But my word, they'd have raised the roof, wouldn't they, if she'd managed to get that double in.
Yeah, you could see she just pulled the dart, put so much into it.
Taylor averaging 110. Here are games to come this evening. John Part against Kevin Painter. On paper, that could be a cracker. Then Daryl Fitton against the ITV wildcard qualifier, Steve Mache.
41.
And finishing up with Mark Webster, the Welshman, against the Dutchman, Vincent van der Voort. Don't blink when he's playing.
Now, some exciting matches coming up. Really looking forward to John Part and Kevin Painter.
43.
Painter always comes to play, as does Jumper.
The power in action, and a lot of people have come to see him. Anastasia's average there would have given her a decent chance against Colin Osborne and Colin Lloyd.
Absolutely. She's not doing a lot wrong.
Taylor just relentlessly advancing towards the victory that we expected. The bookies said 5-0. And so it is working out almost inevitably.
60.
If that dart had gone in, of course. What was it? 111 almost a checkout on
was.
That.
Yep.
Good last dart.
Just going through the motions now. Will he finish off with a bang jump?
Well, he'll want to. He'll want the spectacular finish. Two treble 20s and a double 10 would give him 140. Not to be. Single 20 for double tops.
100.
Well, I think she's done herself proud, Anastasia. I know she won't be happy with her performance. But it's a big ask, taking on the power.
140.
Wonderful throw to finish off with.
Require 40.
Double top then for 5-0 for Phil Taylor. And one dart required. Taylor completes the whitewash. And that, I suspect, is the sort of performance we'll see a great deal from Phil Taylor this week. He beats Anastasia by 5-0. About Phil, and which I have so much admiration for, is that he's achieved so much and yet he's still, as we've said, trimming those flights and still in search of perfection, still getting better.
Well, he's looking for that extra 1 or 2% now to his game. I mean, this is a sport that I never thought I'd see mastered in my lifetime, but he's almost done that. You know, there's nothing else you can say about that man and what he's achieved in what amazes me, it was nearly 20 years ago, he won his first world title.
140!
Well, listen to the reception of the crowd for Anastasia as she produces three terrific darts. From Lusha with love, and they love her in Wolverhampton.
59.
Well, she's got a chance in this leg. Put a bit of pressure on Taylor.
Taylor on 104. Treble would be nice. And gets it. Right, 104.
Treble 18 would be his first star, I would have thought. No. 12 for double 16 and 4 for tops. 4 tops for the first leg.
Game show in the first leg. Phil Taylor.
The glimmer of an opportunity for Anastasia never came, and there's a few pantomime boos from the crowd. And,
he still remains one of the 41. Most popular players on the circuit. The fans absolutely love him, but I think they'd just like to see Anastasia just take the leg and give Phil a bit of a game.
Phil went through a moustache phase a few years ago.
Yeah, he's had a few moustaches.
140.
I'll leave it for others to comment on whether or not it improves the looks.
55.
I think when he won his first title, yeah, he had a moustache.
He had a moustache when he played Dennis, didn't he?
And I'm sure when he played Mike Gregory in that wonderful final. Like I said, that was nearly 20 years ago.
140.
And somehow he just gets better every year. I don't know how he does it.
Yet to get a 180. In this tournament this year, twice the winner, beat Andy Hamilton in the first final, then Terry Jenkins
100.
And looking to set it up here.
Oh, I know we're only into the second leg.
100.
That's pretty handy. Check out the average, Chris. 120.13.
Yeah, that's a little bit special. Once Phil reaches those dizzy heights, you know, he's not really
97.
Going to drop that much, if anything 41. At all, from that. He will now, of course.
Double 16 for the second leg. Anastasia breathes again, but a long way back. He'll have another visit.
Well, she should use this one just as a bit of a practice throw. Try and put a bit of pressure on Phil. Here we go. You see a lot of players at big scores at these points. So they just throw them
100.
Nice and natural.
Fury require 8.
Double 4 for 2-0.
Game shards in the second leg. Phil Taylor.
Fueled by the desire to improve, the desire to win, and accrue a fortune. He's won every, he now holds every single ranking title.
It is remarkable how he keeps raising the bar. And the others have to follow.
100!
Anastasia impressed in her Grand Slam debut last year. You may recall she took Wayne Mardle right to the wire in a memorable group stage game. Based at Ellesmere Port on the Wirral, she's on the brink of moving into the PDC's top 100. And Anastasia has been talking to Ned.
Anastasia, welcome back to Wolverhampton. Last year, you nearly beat Wayne Mardle and you had him very, very worried. Do you have good memories of last year?
Oh, yeah, of course. I'll never forget it. It was such a great experience. So hopefully it's all going to be big plus for me this year.
I'm absolutely sure of that. But what a way to start. Phil Taylor. That's the hardest game in darts, isn't it?
Oh, well, yeah. Well, he's no doubt the best player in the world. And obviously I was so lucky to play him in the first round.
Now, you just told me you have played him before. In fact, it was on Tuesday night in an exhibition. What happened?
Well, yeah, we opened the lane for Riley's in Gillingham, and we had the last game on Mainfield, best of three, and no comment.
No comment?
No.
But maybe you hope for better tonight.
Yeah, much better.
Good luck, Anastasia.
Thank you very much.
Facing Anastasia, a darts player who needs precious little introduction.
Well, Phil, first things first, nice tash.
Thank you, thank you. It's in support of John Artson, that's why I'm groaning. I'm groaning for 1 month, and it's for the cancer, you know, for make people aware what's going on in the downstairs. That's what it's for John.
Very good cause. Now, let's talk about the Grand Slam. And, of course, Phil, this is the third year, and the trophy's got your name written all over it.
Actually, we can't find the trophy. We lost the trophy, believe it or not. So it's obviously it's got my name on it, but not last year because we can't find it. But I'm really. This is a massive tournament on the calendar for us. There isn't one player in here that doesn't want to win this as much as the World Championships. I'll be honest with you, it's a massive tournament for us.
And of course, you're facing Anastasia.
Yeah, it's going to be tough for Anna. It's going to be tough for me, I think. I wouldn't say it was going to be the best game in the world because I think both of us will be a bit respectful of each other, I think. But I'm going to try. I'm going to try my best.
We know you will. Good luck.
Thank you, Jade. Thank you.
The former women's world champion against the current men's world champion at a decidedly noisy and expectant civic hall in Wolverhampton to get the players out once again. John McDonald.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back live to the action. We're at the Wolverhampton Civic Hall. It's the partypoker.com Grand Slam of Darts, brought to you by the Professional Darts Corporation. And we're live on ITV4. Here we go. Ladies and gentlemen, from Russia with love, the former ladies champion of the world, Anastasia Dobromyslova! And now, ladies and gentlemen, would you please welcome the reigning and defending.
He's earned a few quid in the process.
Just a few.
£3.2 million.
60
plus a few exhibitions thrown in.
Oh yeah, that's just his prize money. I wouldn't like to pay his tax bill, that's for sure.
£96 million.
Well, the crowd admiring the brilliance of Taylor, but how they would love to see Anastasia just put herself into a position to maybe win a leg.
40.
Not like that. Wee bit unlucky. You know, aside from those major tournaments, I'm talking about Chris, he's had 12 PDC Pro Tour event victories as well.
Yes,
in 2009.
And I think he only attended 14, I think. His record this year has just been phenomenal.
And today we did
see a rare defeat, all but on the internet, but at Colin Osborne.
Yeah.
Well, in the last game, managed to get a surprise win. Another 19 leaves double 16.
125.
Yeah, he switched upstairs for a 9.
So for 3-0,
it
is turning out to be, I'm afraid to say, from the Russian lady's perspective, it's turning out to be the steamrolling anticipated. And there's leg number 3.
Phil Taylor, fourth leg, Anastasia to throw first. Game on.
Great determination there from Anastasia. She's been unlucky. She's pinning that dart around the 16th. Good switch. That's great dart. That's what she's capable of.
Superb switch, wasn't it? She played in the Grand Slam last year. And it was against Wayne Mardell, wasn't it? He was under a lot of pressure. I think it's what Alex Ferguson calls squeaky
96.
Bum time, isn't it? He just
was.
Came through at the end.
It was memorable, yeah. She played Burra well last year. I think she had a good performance against Kevin McDyne as well, I'm sure.
Indeed.
59.
John Part was the other one in that
That's
group.
That's right. Who's coming up later against Kevin Painter.
140.
Back on 308. Good switch again.
97.
Yep, she's using the board well. Good thinking. 140. Where Taylor's so special from around this point.
This event has grown into a real highlight now of the darts calendar in its third year, and it's a tournament which has been just dominated by Phil Taylor.
125.
Now 125.
Here you go for the ball. 60 now for Tops. The reason he went that way is because he hit the ball. He would have stayed there. At Tops for a 125 and 4-0.
105.
Big chance now for Anastasia.
111, and she's going to get a leg. You suspect that this is the opportunity. That's a great first dart. Tops she requires. Oh, the crowd was just willing that one in.
Grand Slam champion and 14 times champion of the world.
freshly moustached Phil up against Anastasia at the Grand Slam of Darts. That's what Saturday nights are for. In the box for us, Chris Mason and John Rawley.
Thank you, Matt. The Civic Hall here is absolutely rammed. The bars have emptied. There is not a spare seat in the house. And for many a darts fan, Phil Taylor is what it's all about. Now 49 years old and the number one player in the world. The power. You heard him given the big introduction. And is this a thankless task for Anastasia, or will she be sharpened up for the rest of the tournament by the experience of playing against Phil, who we are told, Chris, there we are, ranked number one in the world and twice the Grand Slam champion, has been trimming his flights for even greater effect.
Well, I've just heard this evening, he's actually got an original set of his flights and he started to trim them down himself, and he's been using them for a week, and he says he's better with them than he was before.
The triangular shape there is something he's achieved, and there's Anastasia, 25 years old, lives in Ellesmere Port nowadays, married to Tony Martin, a professional darter himself, and she's got a reputation of being one of the most likeable people on the tour.
Yeah, she's a lovely girl, and she's a fabulous dart player. I've had the privilege of doing exhibitions with her, and she is absolutely superb.
After she's finished here, she'll be heading off for Russia to play in the World Championship qualifiers. I just wonder, is she on a hiding to nothing, or if she does manage to take a leg here, there would be a huge ovation from the crowd.
Absolutely, and it's not beyond her. I mean, this girl can go out in 12 darts, no problem at all. I've seen it, and I've played against it. She's more than capable.
First leg,
it's a big ask, a lot of pressure.
Throw first.
And we know what Taylor's all about. He can beat the best players in the world 5-0.
Well, he averaged that 118, didn't he, in the quarterfinals of the European Open recently, which is just startling. Be a big, big odds-on bet that Taylor wins this one 58. By 5-0, but that's a distinctly fallible and mortal opening. Let's see if Anastasia can capitalise.
Oh, that's just a great first start.
66.
She'll have to shake up a bit of nerves. Problem with this though, John, short course. She's not going to have a lot of time to settle into a rhythm.
If Phil Taylor's going to be vulnerable,
140.
You would suspect it's going to be in these early stages, the short format.
The first three darts.
The thing I find astonishing, this is good from Anastasia,
100.
The thing I find astonishing...